Hi, in this video we will implement moving of our player and we will try to implement filter of view of our player. Let's start. I will create a function with name start moving and in this function I will use path argument, which will be a path array from our state, which we create with function getPath. We need to use this path array to get each element of this array, which will be hexagon, and draw each hexagon. For this I will use setInterval function. I will use it in handleClick function. I will take path from this state path and I will call setInterval function, and inside this function we need to call another function that will draw each hexagon from path array. So I will use start moving function and bind it to this and pass to this function path argument, and I will call this start moving function each 100 milliseconds, and we need a returning value from set interval, which we will use to clear interval when we need it. We will use this interval ID for storing return from set interval function. Okay, and we will move this set state function from handle click to start moving, because in start moving function we're gonna change player position, and after changing player position we need to set state to set this player position in state. Let's check first of all if path array is empty, and if it's empty we will use clear interval with interval ID. Okay, else first of all we will clear our canvas each time when start moving function is calling. Take context of this canvas interaction. And we will clear this canvas. Okay, after we clear it, we need to get an element from array, which will be hex. and we need to get it from the end of path array. So for this I will use current variable, and I will use pop method of array to get last element of path array. Then I'm gonna get column and row of this hexagon. We need to use parse because path store strings of objects. And I'm gonna get x and y coordinates of this hexagon. Okay, and now we just use draw hex function . We'll specify canvas on which we will draw, and we will specify coordinates of center of hexagon. Then we'll specify color of borders and fill color. Okay, let's save and check if it works. Okay, I made a typo here. We don't need to clear React. Okay, we see that our hexagon, our player position, which is yellow color, is moving, but we don't see that our game from object is refreshed every time when we click. So I did something wrong. Let's check. Okay, we need to call the set state in else function. Oh, sorry, in else. Okay, let's refresh. And we see that our came from object is also updated every time when we click. And it's updated according to player position. Okay, let's get rid of drawing our path. So actually we can comment all this because we don't need it anymore. Okay, let's save. Let's click somewhere. Okay. Okay, we see that every time when we click while player is moving, something goes wrong and it stopped moving. That is because we need to clear current set interval function when we click again. So for this we just use clear interval here. This interval ID. Let's save. Let's refresh browser And we will try to click. Okay, we see that it works. It changes direction every time when we click somewhere. Okay, let's now draw our current position, because we don't see it when we refresh, and we don't see it because we don't store X and Y in player position state anymore, and we need to use this hex to pixel function and specify here player position, and we will get object with X and Y. So let's change color to yellow, save, reload. And we don't see our current player position because we don't need this point here also, because it's already an object and we need to convert it to an object again. Okay, we see our initial position of player, and right now I'm going to go to start moving, and we know that in path array we store current player position and then all hexagons from this player position, and when we start moving, when we set interval, each time firstly it takes current player position and draw it, but we don't need to draw player position again here because we already see it, and we spent additional 100 milliseconds to draw this current position of player. So for this we know that we store player position at the end of path array, and we just use path pop to delete last element of the array. So let's check, and we see that it starts moving immediately without spending 100 milliseconds to draw current player position again. Okay, so we now have moving player position. Let's now try to implement simple field of view. We will use line intersection, and to use line intersection we need to cast lines from our current player position to each direction, as much lines as possible, and we need to check if line hits the wall. We need to get coordinates of a point where a line hits the wall and draw line from player position to these coordinates. So we will get field of view. And the hard part of using line intersection is that we have hexagons instead of lines, and we need to check if lines from player position hits every side of hexagon. If we have a lot of obstacles on the map, we will have a lot more sides of these obstacles, and it will be a very big array. It will take time to calculate intersection at each movement. So right now I'm gonna implement a line intersection describing hexagon obstacles as a line. I will take, for example, this wall, and I will get coordinates of this hexagon center and this hexagon center. And now I will take this line and calculate intersection of lines from player position to this line. So for this we will need to cast beams, draw lines from player position to each direction. And for this I will use visible field function. First of all, I will take player position state. From this state, and I will use variable start point of our beams, and use this hex to pixel player position. So we know the center of our player position. Now we need to cast beams from this position, and for this I will use get hex beams chord function, and it will take player position as argument, I, which it will use to calculate angle degree of each beam from player position, and range, which will be distance from player position to beam's end. So I will use here object distraction from player position. Okay, we don't need here to use object distraction because we will pass a start point from this function to this function, and we just need to use our function which we used to get coordinates of each corner of hexagon. It was our get hex corner coordinate. So we will copy that and we will pass it here. And instead of center, we will rename player position to center. And we will rename center start to center here. Okay, so here we have angle degree between lines from the center, and as we have six corners of each hexagon, we have this corner, this corner, this corner, and this corner, and degree between these corners is calculating here. So we will take this get hex beams chord function to cast six beams. So we will use for loop to cast six beams, and at each iteration we will use let beam variable to store result from get hex beam score, and we will specify center I and range will be, for example, 800. Okay, and now we need to use this draw line function, which we used to draw a line between hexagon corners, and we will specify here canvas interaction canvas, and we will use center as starting point of line and beam as end point of line. It's an object with x and y keys. This will be width of line and color of line, yellow. So let's save. Then let's call this function in breadth first search function, because every time when we move, we call breadth first search callback. And here, after updating our came from state, we can use function callback to call this visible field. Okay, let's save. Let's refresh the page. And we have type in callback. We don't need it. Okay. Nothing happens. And nothing happens because we didn't specify range here. In our original function, we use hex size to calculate x and y, and here we will use range because we need very long beams from our player position. So let's save, let's reload the page, and you see tiny beams. I will use opacity in fill hex. Okay, we see these tiny beams. We know coordinates of these beams, and we now can check if they hit the walls. But first of all, let's cast more beams. For this, I will specify here degree to 1 and cast 360 beams. Okay, now we have something that seems like light. Okay, let's get coordinates of the center of these two hexes to draw a line. Okay, I will specify coordinates of these hexagons here. Line start will be coordinates of this hexagon. Actually, let's get coordinates of this hexagon by console log every click. converting current hex to coordinates. Okay. Now we can use these coordinates in visible field. Okay, let's draw the wall. This will be starting point, and this will be end point. And we will use red color. Okay, we see our wall. Now we need to use intersect function. I will copy that function from here. I will leave the link to this function in the description of the video. So we need to create this function line intersect, and it gets two lines. Calculate point of intersecting of these lines, and here are some checkings. Also we have between function, which is for calculating floating numbers. I found this function in the GitHub gist, and I will leave the link to this function. Okay, so now we have line intersect function, and we will use here variable let intersect, and I will use this line intersect function and pass to it center. First of all, first line center x and y, and beam x and y. And then I will pass second line, line start x, line start y, and line end x and line end y. Okay, and we will get point of intersection if lines intersect, and if they are not, we will get false. So we can use if condition. If it's not false, if it's point, then we will draw line, but instead of beam coordinates, we will use intersect coordinates, because it returns object line intersection point. And if it's false, then we cast the beam further. So we will specify beam coordinates. Okay, let's save. Let's reload the page. Okay, we see that we cast beams on the wall, but there's something wrong. Okay, I didn't specify else. Let's save. Okay, now we see how intersection works. If beams hit the wall, line intersection calculate point of heating and pass it to this condition. Then we use point of intersection to draw the line to the wall, and if lines not intersect, then we cast beams further. We see already that this approach has its cons. First of all, we see that beams hit the hexagon, but they gone through. So we need to start to draw a line from point on this side to point on this side. And we see that it gone through these sides, and we need to calculate each wall, and you see that we have here some adjacent hexagons, so we need to calculate this line, then this line, this line, this line, and I don't like this approach. So in the next video I will try to implement solution that will get sides of each hexagon, obstacle hexagon, and then I will check if beam hit side, then I don't need to cast it further. And I already see some difficulties here. How do we know which side of hexagon beam hits first of all? If we know that beam hits this side, then we don't need to cast it to this side. And how we will know that which obstacle is nearest to our player position? Because we can calculate intersection here or here, and we don't know which of these hexagons are nearest to our player position. The first approach that comes into my mind is to use distance to calculate the nearest obstacle to our player position, but it also has its difficulties. So in the next video I will try to implement more efficient and simpler approach to this problem. Thanks for watching.